Masai in second place, Kenenisa Bekele behind him. Mika Kogo of Kenya in fourth, and then there's a gap now. There's Dinkesa, or is it Merga there, of Ethiopia, looks behind. He's wanting to see what's happening behind him, because Abdullah as well is struggling, all because of the pace at the front. This is brutal.
Well, that was over 14.50 from Piatek. 14.58, she moves into the silver medal position.
Thanks, Jonathan. Tedesse not letting this pace drop at all. And they're well stretched out. Masai looks fairly comfortable. Kogo looks comfortable as well, but so does Bekele, right in the middle there, in the green vest of Ethiopia. Let's watch. And they come round this time. They've been clicking off laps in 61 and 62. 62. A 2:35 previous kilometre. This one won't be too much slower. This is hard, Brent. This is really hard in the middle of the race.
It really is. 61, 62, 63, 62, the last four laps. That's why the gaps are opening. That's why the leading group is getting down to manageable numbers. It looks like four of them. Dinkesa just going off the back there in that group, but hanging on, really trying so hard. But four athletes beginning to break away. Zersene Tedesse, another 63-second lap. And this is vicious distance running. And now there are lapped athletes. They're going to have to be winding their way in and out. And there used to be a convention in the old days that when you're becoming lapped, you moved onto the outside. It would be good if that still was a convention, because sometimes it can cause a problem when you've got to go around one or two or even more athletes. But the four of them, Tedesse, his younger brother, just drifting off the back of that leading four. Kenenisa Bekele not looking troubled, but there, the world cross-country champion has just drifted off the pace. Gebre Mariam, he's out of it. So there's an Eritrean, a Kenyan, an Ethiopian, and Mika Kogo, the other Kenyan, in fourth place.
Four are moving away now. And I'm just, while Bren was talking there, trying to remind myself of what happened in 2003 when Kenenisa Bekele and Haile Gebrselassie were in a race where, from about halfway, they wound it up and they ran 12.57, under 13 minutes for the second half of the race. And we're heading in that sort of range here with Tedesse at the front. They're running sub or round about 13-minute pace, a little outside, if you like. So in the front, Tedesse, then Masai, then Bekele, then Kogo, and then a gap which is getting bigger and bigger with every stride to the next group. And they are watching the medals disappear, because this pace, I doubt, will drop too much. I'm not sure there's anything they're going to be able to do from behind. Kipyego's trying to pick them up and trying to take them with him. There's Tedesse's younger brother as well, and Merga looks very tired. But they're what? 20, 25 metres adrift of these four. I'm surprised at Tedesse. It's good to see. I really like watching him run. I think he's a really gutsy runner. I wasn't sure he could come here and run that well. He's watching the screen. He can see what damage he's doing as they go through there with another 63. The only thing I'd say about Bekele, Brent, I think he does look serene, does look good, but I've never seen him look that tired. There's only a couple of times. He doesn't give too much away, does he? You wouldn't expect him to at this point. But they've all got to be working. I know he's brilliant. I know he's the best we've ever seen. But even for him, this is will start to just make him feel a little bit more tired. And he's still got company there, two very good Kenyans.
He is being tested. Zersene Tedesse, is he trying to break away from the field? Or is he just doing enough to get down to a medal position? Zersene Tedesse presses on, keeps going. And they're testing Kenenisa Bekele, and so they should. His teammate Dinkesa, he's had enough. He's taking no further part in this race as he walks off the track, looking back over his shoulder, and he'll see the leading group coming down. They'll see seven laps to go, and still this relentless pace being set by the brave Eritrean athlete, world half-marathon champion, former world cross-country champion. Never won a major title on the track, even though he's medaled in the Olympic Games. Can he win a medal tonight? Can he even win this race tonight? Four of them now, further and further ahead. Kenenisa Fekili settling there in fourth and third place in the middle, plenty room around him. The two Kenyans aren't doing anything yet, and they're all happy to have the pace provided by Zersinay Tedessa. And that was what I was talking about earlier, moving around there, getting around athletes. As Kip Yego leads the second group, it becomes confusing, it becomes difficult, and I don't understand why they don't ask them just to step out.
Well, they maybe should have been aware what was happening behind. Maybe Tedessa doesn't want to waste any breath. He's going to need every single ounce of oxygen he can get into his lungs and into his muscles. As they come round now with six laps to go in this 10,000 final, 63.91 again. This is relentless, and Kogo just looking a little tired for the first time, a little strained. A small gap just starts to appear. It doesn't look like much, does it? But you know, every yard, look at that, suddenly. And then you've got to think, no, get back, get onto it. And every little bit of effort you take to do that is just going to make you a little bit more tired. He's struggling there, Brent. Three starting to break away here.
A silver of Portugal further down the field. And now Tedessa looks up to the screen and he'll get some encouragement as he sees Mika Kogo suddenly go 10 yards out the back door. In third place, it's Kenenisa Bekele. In front of him, it's Masai, whose sister won the 10,000 metres. She was surprised. She was as surprised as we were the way she won it in the finishing straight. And Zersinay Tedessa, the pressure of leading. He's been leading for about the last eight laps, but those 62, 63-second laps, and now he's keeping it going, a 64-second lap, and there's three of them there. There's a yard or two he's stolen. Is he trying to break this away? Is this his effort to try and break the field? The medals look as though they're going in that direction. Eritrea, Kenya and Ethiopia. Which order? We don't know. And is this a brave effort by the tough Eritrean athlete? Looks over his shoulder. He's got a yard or two. Has he got enough yards or two?
Bekele, as ever aware, realises the gap is growing, just moves out, smoothly glides past Masai, who could add to his family's medal haul here, but is he watching the gold and the silver disappear? These are two of the greatest distance runners we've ever seen, Zersinay Tedessa, and he's had to play second fiddle on so many occasions to Kenenisa Bekele. And he's doing his best here, though. Bekele, I think, is just beginning to feel this a little bit now. It's not to say that he can't go with it, but this is hurting. 62, that's a real effort from Tedessa. He's picked it up again. Now, this is really, really fast running. I'm really, really impressed by Tedessa. This has got to be hurting Bekele, Brent.
It's hurting them both. And I've just had some information from Mark Butler, our statistician, and he tells me they've just run 7.50 for 3,000 metres, the last 3,000 metres. And that's incredible. That's a decent time for 3,000 metres itself, let alone the fact it's in the middle of another 7,000 metres. So Zersinay Tedessa, the hard man of the cross-country, the hard man of the roads, becoming the hard man of the track and testing the great one, Kenenisa Bekele. He's now got one athlete for company, and he's done it the hard way. He's done it all himself. He didn't have any help from his teammates. He didn't have any help from anybody else. He decided with about 14 laps to go that he was going to try and make it tough. He's going to try and make it tough for Kenenisa Bekele. And Bekele has just had to follow, dig deep, concentrate on the back of Zersinay Tedessa and just keep it going. And I think the athletes are getting a little bit irritated, Steve, by the behaviour of the bear.
I wish somebody would trip that mascot up, I really do. He's just, I know he's trying to interest the crowd, but there's a great race going on here and he doesn't need to be running alongside the athletes like that. Tedessa is flying here. He knows he's got to put the pressure on here. He knows he can't leave it to the last 200 metres. He's got to hurt Bekele. 2:35 through that kilometre. And I think the last 5,000 metres must have been close to 13 minutes because he started this just before the halfway point. And they're going to run a superb time. The championship record is 26:49. He won't be bothered about that at the moment. Masai's in the bronze medal position. He'll have to keep going over these last few laps. He's a long way clear of anybody behind him in terms of fourth. Fourth was the position that Tedesse finished in Osaka in this race, in this final. Not this time. He's at the front. He's pushing hard. 63.06. Bekele's hurting, but he's close. He's at hand. And he knows with every lap that goes by now, the gold medal, the sprint finish, is something which he can start to look forward to. 700 metres to go.
Another 63-second lap. Zerzanay Tedesse has been absolutely amazing. He's applied the pressure of leading, and Kenenisa Bekele's had an easy ride, and if he can have an easy ride running at this sort of pace. 600 metres remaining. If there's any gap to be opened, it's got to be soon, because we all know how powerful the great Kenenisa Bekele is. He's never known defeat over 10,000 metres. He's moving up onto the outside, getting ready to make his move. He's never been beaten at 10,000 metres. This is his 12th race. Is this going to be his fourth world championship? Is he going to take revenge on the man that stopped his streak of world cross-country titles, Zerzanay Tedesse? The bell sounds. Kenenisa Bekele opens out and attacks immediately and really starts to race. And down the back straight, he's looked over his shoulder. He certainly is being questioned. And then that few yards just open amazingly.
He wasn't going to wait any longer. The impatience was written on his face as he approached the bell. He looks as though this could be his best ever championship performance in a 10,000 metres. As we were saying, he's unbeaten. He has a career of unparalleled victories. He's going to add to it here. It'll be another world title. He puts his finger up as number one. He is the number one. He's always been the number one since he was very young. He stretches away down the home straight. It's going to be another gold medal for Kenenisa Bekele in superb style. The championship record will be his as well. It is a brilliant, brilliant run from him. Tedesse made the record, wins the silver medal. The two friends hug. Masai takes the bronze for Kenya. Simply stunning from Bekele. Nothing you can do, no tactics you can employ. That was as good as I think I've seen anyone try to take him on. That's as hard as I've seen anyone make it. And even then, maybe three laps out, maybe two laps out, he was hurting a little bit. But when he got into the last 600, he was itching to go past Zerzanay Tedesse. We all knew what was going to happen on the last lap. He knew as well. He did as much as he could. But unless you're going to run a world record or something, you can't run away from this man, from Kenenisa Bekele. As we watch the athletes coming through, there'll be some quick times in there. There's some athletes have run pretty fast. But goodness me, what's that, 12 out of 12? And I'm sure more to come.
Kenenisa Bekele, the great one. Absolutely fantastic. His fourth world title, two Olympic titles, four world titles. And the rest of the field has been decimated. We don't even know what laps some of these athletes are on. It's been so much spoiled. But that was a fantastic performance by Zerzanay Tedesse. He tested Kenenisa Bekele. He gave it everything he possibly could. There was no more left. And there they come to the bell. Zerzanay Tedesse has been leading for the last 13 laps, for the last 5,000 metres. And then suddenly off goes the great man, the great Kenenisa Bekele. He attacks, and suddenly the gap opens so quickly and so rapidly down the back straight, and that is absolutely amazing. He's a true sprinter in every sense. And interestingly, we're getting statistics about this performance. The second 5,000 metres tonight, he's run in 13 minutes and 5 seconds. As he comes round, begins to relax, begins to take it easy, begins to salute the crowd, and then Kenenisa Bekele. I think this man will eventually become the greatest distance runner of all time. And when you look at whose company that means, it means Miroslav Yifta, it means Lassie Viren, it means Vladimir Kutz, it means Emil Zatopek, and it goes back to 1912 to Hannes Kolomainen. This is the greatest of them all. And you know what? The Ethiopians have never won the 5,000 metres in the World Championships. I wonder what he's going to be doing in a couple of days' time. If he does it, I don't think anybody can beat him in that either. He is absolutely unbelievable. And looking at his time, Steve, 26.45. His previous 11 10,000 metre races, his average time was 26.45. He's kept his average by running 26.45 again tonight.
Well, I tell you what, you go and tell him he's just had an average run, because I'm not.